Now we can follow the calcination. Calcination. Now we can follow the calcination. Now children, we can discuss the calcination. What is the meaning for calcination? Calcination means an ore is heated in absence of air or oxygen. In absence of air or oxygen. An ore is heated. An ore is heated. An ore is heated in absence of air. In absence of air or oxygen. Or oxygen. This process is used for a carbonate ore. Here one small doubt is present. That is roasting and calcination. Both processes are heated process or are pyrochemical process. Pyro means heat. Heated process. But in presence of air or oxygen, but it is in absence of air or oxygen. What does it mean for in presence and absence? Outside of the heat is required for this roasting, and outside heat is not required for a calcination process. It is the main difference. Outside heat is required for roasting. Outside heat is not required for a calcination process. That's why we have told you, ore is heated in absence of air or oxygen. Now we can observe calcination. Example, this process is used for a carbonate ore can be converted into oxide ore. Carbonate ore can be converted into oxide ore. Like we can take as one example, ZnCO3 utilized to ZnO plus CO. ZnO plus CO2. This is called about calcination process. This is called about a calcination process. After this calcination and roasting process, we can follow a very very important method that is called as a self reduction or auto reduction. Self reduction process and auto reduction. Self reduction or auto. Auto reduction. Auto reduction. Or it is also called as self reduction process. Already we know about oxidation and reduction in previous classes. What is the meaning for oxidation and reduction? Oxidation means by the adding of oxygen or removal of hydrogen or loss of electrons, we can call as oxidation. Reduction means removal of oxygen or addition of hydrogen or gain of electrons or addition of electrons, we can call as a reduction. Now we can follow auto reduction or self reduction. In this process we can use for blister or maybe copper sulfide. When react with 2 moles of copper sulfide, when react with oxygen to form 2Cu2O plus 2SO2. 2SO2. This is the first step. And another step is Cu2S plus Cu2O used as 6Cu plus SO2. Why this is called as auto reduction or self reduction? In this process, copper sulfide when react with cuprous sulfide or copper sulfide when react with copper oxide to form copper metal. In this process, we can observe, we can remove the oxygen from copper oxide. From copper oxide. That's why in this process is called as auto reduction or self reduction. Auto reduction or self reduction. And next one, and in this auto reduction or self reduction, after this auto reduction or self reduction process, we can follow a very very important method that is called as a displacement. Displacement. Displacement reaction. It is also called as important question for this in this lesson. Displacement reaction or Thermite process. Already you know displacement reaction. Displacement reaction means a low reactive elements are low reactive metals are replaced by high reactive metals, or are low reactive elements are replaced by high reactive elements. That is called as a displacement reaction. Why this is called as Thermite process? In this process we can absorb. In this process we can absorb some metals are like a low reactive metals. A low reactive metals are replaced by highly reactive metals. Highly reactive metals. Those are potassium, sodium, aluminium, and those are types of reactions. We can low reactive metals nothing but here we can consider moderative reactive, not low reactive. Low reactive metals nothing but moderative reactive metals are replaced by highly reactive metals. And in this process we can call as a Thermite process. Are low reactive metals are replaced by highly reactive metals like potassium, sodium and aluminium and calcium. That is called as a Thermite process. And Thermite process is a exothermic reaction. In this Thermite process, heat is released. More amount of heat is released for this Thermite process. Where we can use for this Thermite process? By the joining of railway cracked places. Joining of railway cracked places. Like some railway tracks are cracked. Those cracks are filled with some amount of metals. That is called as a Thermite process. Now we can observe Thermite process. Like we can use it for Thermite process is the exothermic reaction. And by the joining of railway cracked places with the help of some metals, that is called as Thermite process. In this Thermite process we can observe aluminium is used. That's why it is also called as aluminium thermite process. See children, why it is also called as aluminium thermite process? Aluminium metal is used for the process of joining of railway tracks. That's why we can call as aluminium thermite process. Now we can observe this aluminium thermite process. Example is like Al plus Fe2O3 used rise to Al2O3 plus 2Fe plus heat. That is 2Al plus Fe2O3 used rise to Al2O3 plus 2Fe. And another example is Cr2O3 chromic oxide plus aluminium used rise to Al2O3 plus 2Cr plus heat. In this process, two reactions are a low reactive metals or maybe moderative reactive metals. Fe is replaced by aluminium and Cr is replaced by aluminium. That's why this is called as a displacement reaction. And it is the one type of example. Another type of examples like a titanium tetrachloride is reacted with magnesium in presence of 850 degrees Celsius to form titanium plus magnesium chloride. Titanium plus magnesium chloride. And in this process also we can use for titanium is replaced by magnesium. Titanium is replaced by magnesium. And another example is titanium tetrachloride plus 4 moles of sodium. We can absorb in presence of 850 degree Celsius to form titanium plus 4 moles of sodium chloride. It is another type of example for this displacement reaction. But we can take it as aluminium and react with Fe2O3. In Fe2O3, Fe is replaced by Al and Cr is replaced by Al. These two are the examples for aluminium Darmian process. But these two are the examples for another type of displacement reaction. Another type of displacement reaction. This is called about the extraction of moderative reactive metals. All understood, children? Once again, I will explain extraction of moderative reactive metals. Then follows a roasting method, and next we can absorb a calcination process. After roasting and calcination process, in those two processes, a sulfide ore and a carbonate ores are converted into oxide ores. In those oxide ores, when react with carbon and carbon monoxide to form those respective metals. That process is called as a reduction with carbon carbon monoxide. And after we can follow auto reduction or self reduction process. And auto reduction and self reduction process, after we can follow the displacement reaction for our Darmian process. After these extraction of moderative reactive metals, last and final we can follow the extraction of low reactive metals. Extraction of low reactive metals. Now we can follow the extraction of low reactive metals. Extraction of low reactive metals. Extraction of low reactive metals. Now we can follow extraction of low reactive metals. Low reactive metals. Which metals are called as low reactive metals? Like some metals like mercury, silver, platinum and gold are belongs to low reactive metals. Those metals are generally available in the form of free state or a native state. Free state or a native state. But in some conditions it is also available in the form of compound state. Like sulfides and some amount of sulfides also available. Like for example, silver and mercury is available in the form of sulfides in a least amount or lowest amount. Now we can absorb, we can take as silver sulfide. This is called as cinnabar. 2 moles of cinnabar. When react with oxygen to form 2HGO plus 2SO2. 2SO2. See here we can take as 2 moles of cinnabar when react with 3 moles of oxygen to form 2HGO. 2HGO by applying of heat. By applying of heat. And now we can take it as a 2HGO is decomposed in presence of heat to form directly metal and oxygen. It is a special for this low reactive metals. Low reactive metals. In this low reactive metal process, mercuric sulfide when react with oxygen to form mercuric oxide, because mercuric oxide undergoes heating to form mercury and oxygen. Directly can produce mercury and oxygen. And after in this process we can follow the displacement. Displacement reaction. Already you know displacement. Low reactive metals are replaced by highly reactive metals. in this process like a silver is replaced by cyanides of potassium and zinc. Cyanides of potassium and zinc. Now we can observe displacement reaction. Here we can take as silver sulfide. When we react with cyanide of potassium, aqueous form of cyanide of potassium, like we can take as cyanide of potassium to form 2AgCN taken twice minus plus S2 minus, like in the form of aqueous. It is also the form of aqueous. Now we can absorb 2AgCN taken twice minus when react with the zinc metal. React with the zinc metal to form ZnCN taken 4 times 2 minus plus 2Ag. 2Ag plus. 2Ag plus. Like it undergoes or it is reacted with. It is reacted with. And directly can produce a metal, silver. In this process we can observe. In this process we can absorb a silver metal is replaced by zinc. Silver metal is replaced by zinc. That's why this is called as a displacement reaction. That's why this is called as a displacement reaction. This is called about extraction of gold metal from its ore. Extraction of crude metal from its ore. Once again, I will explain all. First one, extraction of crude metal from its ore. Extraction means we can get the crude metal from its respective ores by the usage of or using of reactivity series. Highly reactive metals, moderately reactive metals, and low reactive metals. Based on those reactivity, it is extracted by usage of different type of process. Different type of process. This is called about extraction of crude metal from its ore. Okay? And after this extraction of crude metal from its ore, we can follow the last and final step, that is called as the refining process or purification of a crude metal.